हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू इंग्लिश क्लास। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर आई टॉट यू हाउ टू चेंज इम्पेरेटिव सेंटेंस इनटू इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच एंड टुडे वी शैल स्टडी हाउ टू चेंज ऑप्टेटिव सेंटेंसेस इनटू इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच। फॉर दिस आई हैव टेकन सो मेनी एग्जांपल्स, यू कैन सी ओवर हियर। बट बिफोर making you understand about the rules, I wanna ask you, what do you understand by optative sentence? So you know very well what is the meaning of optative sentence. Optative sentence is also a kind of sentence which express what prayer or wish, or it may be also curse. You can see examples of optative sentence. The first sentence I have taken over here, he said, may you have a happy journey. So the rule says that according to the nature of the sentence we will write wished, blessed, prayed. Okay, so here we are getting a sense of what wish, so we will write in place of said, we will write wished. He wished that, we will remove this double inverted comma, and in place of this double inverted commas I will write here that. This you will be converted into I, so it will become, he wished that I might have a happy journey. Now come to the next one. The saint said to me, may you live long. The saint said to me, may you live long. Here indirect speech will be, the saint blessed me. Why it is blessed me? Because you know very well, you know the nature of the saint. Saint always used to give blessings. So here is also giving blessing, may you live long. So we can write here, the saint blessed me that, we will remove this double inverted comma, and in place of this we will write here that. I might live long. Remaining changes will be according to the previous taught rules. Got it? Now come to the next example. They said, long live the king. You can change this direct speech into indirect speech like this. They wished that the king might live long. How it happened? We just changed this said into what wished. We removed this double inverted comma and wrote here that. And then the king might live long. This is according to the rule that already I taught you. Now come to the next one. The preacher said to me, may God help you. So what would be the indirect speech of this sentence? The preacher prayed that God might help me. Why I prayed word used over here? I used prayed word here because we are getting a sense of what prayer. That is why I wrote over here. The preacher prayed that, we will remove this one and we will write here that. God might help me. So these are few examples. With the help of these examples, you can understand how we can change optative sentence into indirect speech. Now come to the important point. While you are changing, while you are making optative sentences, or while you are changing optative sentence into indirect speech, so the rule says that if you are getting a sense of wish, then you have to write wished in place of said. Now if you are getting a sense of blessings, okay, then you have to write blessed word in place of this said word. Now the third rule says that if you are getting a sense of prayer, then you will write prayed in place of this said. And After that, you have to use a conjunction, and the conjunction is that. And after that, you have to use whatever is given modal actually verb. According to that only you have to change, by keeping in mind the rules of narration or direct and indirect speech.